Good afternoon. I'm Daniel Miller, and this is Dibbon introducing Lit Nightmares 2. A warm welcome to all of our friends, fans, community members and viewers on various platforms set worldwide. Thank you for joining us and thank you for being here with us today for our next episode of the Abigail Introducing. Today we are looking at Little Nightmares 2. We already had another session which was giving us a very, very good picture of Immortals Phoenix Rising, a game we talked about here on the channel quite a bit during the last few months. And today we'll be looking at this one, the game that's been released on Xbox and other platforms very recently in February and had been recommended to us by various people in line. So without further ado, we'll just crack on and have a look at all that is to follow. We had this game on the list for a little while, and I know that both Larry and Jeff from Xbox talked about it quite a bit about its release, but today we are looking at the game in depth. We'll be first of all examining how the game was made and all that indeed was preceding its release, and then we'll be cracking up with some action. So first of all, this Little Nightmares 2 game is a puzzle platformer horror adventure game developed by Tarsier Studios, also published by Bandai Namco. You'll be familiar with Bandai Namco through many other games we streamed here on the channel. It is sequel. It is the sequel to 2017 Little Nightmares, another game from the series, and features a new player character, a little boy called Mono, with the protagonist from the previous game. So Six appearing as a computer-controlled character. The story follows Mono, who must work together with Six to survive the horrors of the Pale City and discover its dark secrets. The game was released for Microsoft Windows, Stadia, Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, literally across the board, on 11th of February 2021. That's roughly 4 weeks ago. I watched some of the trailers and developer diaries, and they were really very, very interesting, very curious, waiting for the game to be introduced here, but we didn't have a slot, and you know, the right time had arrived today, so there we are. I think the versions for the next gen are likely to be released later this year, and that will be for Xbox Series X and S as well as PlayStation 5. The game received very positive reviews upon release, with critics praising its graphics, atmosphere and sound while criticizing its controls. So we'll pay attention to that, and we'll obviously be able to find out more as we crack on. As said, developer is Tarsier Studios, publisher is Bandai Namco. The director of this game, well, isn't one, four directors: Pierre Bergman, Gustav Heinewald, Denis Talaich and Victor Lidang. So it's similar to its predecessor. It takes place in a 2.5D world. The player must explore the world, occasionally encountering platform-like situations or being blocked by puzzles that must be solved to proceed. Unlike the first game, the player is not completely helpless. Mono has the ability to grab certain items, swing them back to break objects, or to fight back against similar foes, although he, like Six, remains more or less helpless against larger foes and must rely on stealth and the environment to hide or run from them. The player is also given make sure they stay together, must often work together with to solve environmental puzzles and defeat or evade enemies. The game also features collectible hats and leeching remains, the latter of which will unlock an additional scene upon collecting them all. The game was announced at Gamescom 2019 as the sequel to the original Little Nightmares. A demo for the game was released on 30th October 2020. It's been around for about roughly 5 months. On February the 20th of 2021, Dossier, which was acquired by Embracer Group in 2019, announced that they would not continue making Little Nightmares games. The publisher Bandai Namco Entertainment expressed an intent to continue the franchise in the future. Sadly, as it happens frequently, once you're acquired by another group, there will be some issues popping up, and I'm sad to see that, because obviously the company was involved with both games, and evidently the new terms and conditions, i.e. the publisher interference with the actual game making, would have played an important part. I assume, I've not had any other news on this, but that is what happens frequently, and we've seen that with lots of different developers. Small developers were acquired by the bigger organization, therefore having these issues popping up fairly soon. Alright, so as I said, the overall experience of the game was very positive, and we did see lots of very good reviews everywhere. I'm personally very curious to see how Little Nightmares will perform compared to the original. So, without further ado, we'll crack on with the new game. Love the animations in here. Hats. Okay. Similar to what we've seen in Tim Burton's films, you know, animated films with a twist. Look like games for children, but actually, we're very far from that. Oh, I can't go up there now. Why? Boo! What's the reason for that? Can I jump? Okay, let's walk around here and see whether there's going to be a way through. No, we're not going to be able to get out of there. Reminds me of Ori a bit, I think. Evidently, Ori is a feel-good game. I think this one, maybe. So when we fall down there, what do we do? How do we get up there? Okay, we need to go all the way back. Anything else for us to to look at in here. Doesn't look like it. No. So there's got to be some around here that we need to go to. Hold R2 and move L to drag. Where? Oh, it's right. So we're going through the tunnel. Take a screenshot of him. Ah, we found something. Can we collect? Well, we'll find. Oh, look at this. That's not very pretty, is it? What on earth is happening here, you wonder? To get up there. That's a bit odd. I think that's probably what they complained about the controls. That was the main complaint that various online entities were describing. I should be able to get up there. I think. Hold R2 to grab ledges. Yeah, that's really poor because if we've gone. Yeah, that doesn't really work. I got this message after I already tried it like 50 times. Try to remember it. And then we need to jump. Okay. Grab ledges, now it worked. Okay. And that's the end of me. I think. How am I going to be able to avoid this? Alright, I found a way. That was nice and easy. No rocket science. Is this the trap as well? We'll have to push this all along. Very good. That was fine. I got up. Well, you could see the reason as to why you had to do it. It's really a survival game. You need to avoid all the traps and everything else that you have in your way. Seen. There's a spot in there where I can hide. So the idea is to be running down to the path. I think I worked it out. All the way down there. I didn't survive. Okay. I survived. I'm good. Look at that. Slightly tricky, but managed to get that. Grab ledges. What was it? Not that. Can't run from here. Okay. That will certainly not work. But maybe if I was to jump on top there, maybe? Or not? Let's see. Jump? No. No, no, not happening. Well, I think I know what we need to do in here. We need to probably go inside and then try to jump out. No? No, not work. Yeah, did a nice jump in, but to jump out, okay, so that is the forgotten bit, but that noose in there almost certainly has something to do with it. To do with that noose. We need to find out what to do with it. So I got it. Need to go up here and then all the way up to come here and then printing. No, it's not. I need to find out whether he can sprint and jump, because that's what he probably needs to do in here. Oh, I did manage to get there. Okay. So it wasn't about the noose, it was about... It was about the run. Maybe it can go from here. No, no. Well, that's tricky. That's tricky. Missed the jump on that bit in the middle. Jump. That's really the trouble with those controls. They were right. The controls are not really very good here on consoles. No, I'll try just to jump them ordinarily. No, I don't like. It took me so long to get there. Boo! Okay, grapple. Yeah, got it. Tricky old platformer, hey? Beautiful design, but you really need to master everything that you're doing here. Yes. Yeah, and the message in there was coming a bit late after I've done it already 50 times. Swing and then press X. Well, you know, we're swinging and Xing, but sprinting, I think. Yeah, it looks like it. Oh, missed the jump. Didn't really respond to X. Which is strange, not sure why. Okay, didn't jump properly. Well, this is a tricky bit. Double trouble there. Right, so finally managed to grapple in there. Nearly fell. So it's not really. Okay. Thank you. did manage to get this done with a lot of difficulty. There we are. Pushed on. apologize to my friends for this unexpected break, but I can tell you I just had a phone call that booked me in for COVID vaccine, and I'm delighted. I've been waiting for that for some time, and I'm on the priority level listings, and both dates have been booked, so that's wonderful. I waited for that. I knew that it was going to be happening within the next week or two, because I received my seasonal flu vaccine on the 16th of January, and it's usually 6 weeks, 6 to 7, maybe sometimes even 8 weeks in between before you are able to be receiving a COVID vaccine. So that's really good, and I've got it booked in for Saturday after next, and after that I'll have another, I think they said beginning of June, so that will be 8 weeks later. So all looking back, make this out, end of March, and that would be then, yeah, it's about 9 weeks later, 8 to 9 weeks later. Nevertheless, I'm feeling very, very happy and very encouraged, and that is really good news. That made my day, that made my week. I'm really happy. I was just saying to the lady in there, I've been spending 22 hours indoors, and for more than a year, I went into the quarantine on the 4th of March of last year. Obviously, I'll have to adhere to the same measures and the same rules and everything else. The collateral will persist here for a long while, but being vaccinated will help, and I think we'll have a kind of experience of enlightening taking place, where you know that the vaccine's there, and therefore you're no longer as exposed or as vulnerable as otherwise. So I would just advise all of our viewers, all of our friends and community members, if you are being called up for your vaccine, do not hesitate, do not wait, just have it. And you will need to state all the other health conditions that you may have, and you need to really make sure that your GP, your doctor, is fully aware of any allergies or any other known conditions. We have seen that people with certain conditions were experiencing some side effects, and I think so far we've seen no fatalities, certainly none in the UK, but you know on the continent there have been some issues, and it just all I think it's very important you consult your GP or specialist if you are receiving any of the treatment, and then discuss all the issues with them. And we have the priority and the privilege that indeed we're manufacturing our own vaccine in Britain, which obviously made it possible for us to vaccinate already, I think, more than 23 million people so far. And we did see that on the continent there have been many, many issues, and their vaccination program is seriously delayed due to many other administrative and industrial factors, I would say. And, we can be very, very happy. We certainly, as a country that suffered the most on the European continent, we have been very quick and very assertive in the process of which we've built infrastructure for all that was to follow. And as you can see, it's working presently very, very well. So once again, I'm having my vaccine done in a week. That is week on Saturday. And that's just wonderful news. I'm delighted. That's all I can tell you. So I apologize for this break, but you understand, we all want to have that sort of information ironed out as soon as possible. How did I cross there? I wonder. We have that rope in there. Okay. Probably we're going to grapple. Well, that's better than the other jump that I have to go through. Hang on. Yep. Be careful, you do not fall. Well, the game is very enjoyable. I think there are significant problems with controls. We're not getting pop-up messages telling us what we need to be doing, and the controls feel stiff. If you want to be grappling or anything else, but I guess the very beginning is always the most difficult and the hardest. Can we go up there? Maybe. It's not that. Didn't see the trap. Bolt to grab objects. Press that. Shoe. Okay. Okay, we'll pick up this one. Okay. And then we need to... How did I throw that? What did I do? Now I forgot. One of them I need to pick up, and then... There! That was clever. This instance it worked. Okay, grapple that. Can I go up? Maybe not. Okay, that worked. That was a steep jump. I knew it! Why did I walk into this trap? Just plain stupid. That's just what it was. Brainless. Just don't think about it. To avoid the traps when you see them. Plenty of traps, and they're semi-concealed, to be fair. Okay. Maybe pick this up, eh? That was clever. That was well done. I'm pleased with myself. Okay. Our community member Hunter was telling me about the game. He said he watched Developer Diaries and he quite liked the animation. All the things. And oh, look at this. This is a field full of traps, and these traps are very hidden. I think he's right. Game is definitely very much of a sort of game that everybody wants to try, and I knew it. I knew the trap was going to be there. I knew the trap was going to be there. I just knew. From there. Oh, I'm succeeded. That's good. I bet the traps are going to be there as well. Yep. I knew it. I knew it. I knew it. I knew it. avoid. Is that not possible? Damn it. Difficult. Or maybe from there, I don't know. Something there to block this off. Not sure what though. I know what it is. I know what it is. I know what I need to do. I just didn't cotton on. There's several of these now we can use, and I just didn't register. I jumped again. Why was that? Did press twice. Should have been jumping higher than that. The controls are definitely a serious weakness in here. Honestly, it's making it tricky and you need to replace something several times to get there. It's not necessary, really. Right, so CDs. These ones I need to pick up. That was ridiculous. This one also, look at that. Threat. Could have been something else.
about is okay. Should be able to go there, look at this. I won't be able to go up, I need to go up there. Come on. All sorts of traps in here, as you could see. Not allowing me to get in. Wait a minute, we'll get in here. Oh, it's pretty, doesn't it? Very nicely designed, this game is. It's a platformer, but you don't actually have a feeling that you're playing a kind of a platform-based game, which I think is obviously its biggest strength. This up. Well, That's very unfortunate, because with this cleaver I could have been breaking this. Don't think I can pick it up anymore. And that brings us to the end of our presentation today of Little Nightmares 2. Thank you for watching, and thank you for enjoying it and supporting the channel, and thank you for being valued members of our community. We have two games introduced today, Little Nightmares 2, obviously this one, and then Immortals Fenyx Rising earlier this afternoon. So if you're interested, just have a look at all the playback there on my channel. Just hit that play button and you'll see it. I've got to say, I'm delighted I've been introducing those two games. Both are very different. Immortals is a AAA blockbuster Ubisoft made game that came out last year, and really a terrific game with elements of quite a selection of RPGs we played over the years. Zelda, probably one of the most the most popular ones that comes to mind, and also having some resonance with Dragon Quest XI and with Assassin's Creed Odyssey, due to its subject taking place in Greece, and the gods are kind of discussing what to do with the humans. And very enjoyable game, really good, very smooth gameplay, beautiful graphics, and massive big open world. And as you've seen in here, this is just bringing us to the world of what? Tim Burton. Certainly had a block, couldn't remember. Although Tim Burton has not been involved with this game, he is the major influence. Anyone who's familiar with his works will tell you he does exactly the same on the silver screen. And in here, we are protagonists. We are playing the lead character. So anyone who is a Tim Burton fan, who played Nightmare Before Christmas or all the other wonderful animated and feature films he made, will recognize those elements here, and I'm quite certain you will enjoy the activity. So I most highly recommend you this game if you're a Tim Burton fan. But now we are going to be migrating to the world of Apex Legends. Apex Legends is undergoing at the moment yet another event. It is called Chaos Theory. And similar to what we had recently with its 2-year anniversary, we are to be grinding in order to get gamer points and XPs, and then we are being given lots of different rewards. So that is what we'll be doing today for the rest of our broadcast, and hopefully some of you will pop in and join us. Certainly hoping that you're also a gamer who enjoys Apex. And Larry and Jeff of Xbox did say that they thought Apex was one of the most enjoyable games they've ever come across, and certainly was carrying the beacon for them during the pandemic. And I agree. And particularly the concept that we have presently there, with fewer than the original 50 teams, at the moment only 20, which made the map a lot wider, more tactical, and therefore the game has become a lot more enjoyable. Each event will have some invention, something new thrown in. In the course of Chaos Theory, we are getting the pop-up circles within the map, and they have some gas inside and they're very deadly. Still haven't worked out how to survive them. I got killed a couple of times yesterday, but I had my victory, the victory yesterday within the Chaos Theory's event, and also I had a couple of seconds in third, so you know, it was a good day. So we'll carry on today, hoping to get more XPs in order to basically get our hands on all the lovely rewards that the Respawn is offering. So, without further ado, I thank you all for watching.
will carry on with Apex very shortly. Stay with us and indeed join us with that wonderful, wonderful Kings Canyon world. All is to follow in about 5 minutes, and see you shortly.